I'm telling you.
Lego. It's all about the young money. Feminist.
What we gonna do right here is go back. Way back. Back into time.
Old school hip hop, the era of breakdancing, b-boys, and graffiti. During the 1970s in Bronx, New York, low-income communities were filled with the children of minorities who needed a way out. Other than living in poverty, violence in these communities was also a problem. No matter what they did, they knew their voices would not reach outside the Bronx. But suddenly, that all changed. What started as the Block Party movement, where DJs would throw parties and the young adults of the Bronx would come together and have a good time, evolved into the great culture we know today, hip-hop. In what ways have hip-hop influenced your life?
Hip-hop is a culture, so there's so many aspects of hip-hop that have influenced my life through music, through dance, even through art, even though I'm not an actual artist myself when it comes to painting or drawing. It speaks to me, and because I am a dancer, I can use every aspect of hip-hop to evolve what I like to call dance.
How do you think hip-hop as a music genre has changed?
I definitely think that hip-hop music has changed a lot. I was born in the 80s, and I feel like back then it spoke more about things that need to be changed, about, you know, everyday life. And now hip-hop, it has a lot of influence of, you know, the young people, of what y'all feel like y'all think y'all going through. To me, it's not that great, but, you know, it happens. It's still expressive. So that's one way to stay the same. But, you know, with the whole speaking about, a lot of them go dancing or girls and all that kind of stuff. And I feel like hip-hop originated from a real place of struggle. And I don't feel like it shows that.
When you have nothing else, you have music. Old school hip-hop brought attention to the struggles that went on in New York because people started rapping about it. It was a common experience people shared, and their voices were heard in a more effective way than violence. From then on, hip-hop became a movement, a highly effective one at that.
Feminist. A person who believes in the social, political, and economic equality of the sexes.
Yo, you smashed that one.
What impact are you personally trying to make by working in hip-hop?
I work with youth, and my impact that I'm trying to make is to show them another way of expressing themselves through dance, with hip-hop dance or any style dance. But since we're talking about hip-hop dance, you know, because y'all are the new generation and what you are putting out is what you all consider hip-hop, you know, there's still some expressive ways that I can still pull from my hip-hop to give you.
Transitioning into the 80s, hip-hop broke out of New York and started expanding all over the United States. Artists were sampling or creating songs out of old ones, using songs from James Brown, for example. This is where experimentation was prominent, and so many different styles were created. You had artists like Run-DMC come out with their gold chains and Adidas and rock and roll inspired songs. You had the BC Boys, whose outrageous videos and catchy lyrics proved that they could make it in the industry like any other black artist. You also had the women make a debut, like Salt-N-Pepa and Queen Latifah. Their feminist mindset and talents enforced girl power and also showed that they could keep up with the boys. Also, this is when hip-hop became pop culture and mainstream due to songs like Walk This Way by Aerosmith and Run DMC.
120. What's the word? 120. Let's get in. And here's an ode to the worst of my days. I've been working away, but the sky's been looking so gray. Sometimes I really need to get away. I just need to get away. I could never forget them gloomy days, although I regret where my time was placed. If I could go back, some things would be changed, and I would know that for a fact it was fame that drew me to this unfamiliar side of my brain that would drew me for familiar and the closest to maze. Although I'm gaining ends now, I'm losing friends. They say that time is...
Excuse me, but Lady Liberty needs glasses, and so does Mr. Justice by her side. Both brides are blind as bats. Stumbling through the system, Justice bumped in Matulu, stumbling on Geronimo Pratt, but stepped right over Oliver and his crooked partner. Justice stubbed her big toe on Mandela, and slavery was misquoted by the Indians. Slavery was a learning phase, forgotten without verdict. While Justice is on a rampage. I mean, really? Really? If anyone valued life and cared about the masses, take both. Two pins optical and get two pairs of glasses.
You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Now that hip-hop put the East Coast on the map, it was time for the West Coast to tell their story. This era outlines one of the most violent moments in American history. The Rodney King beating of 1991 is what led to the famous LA riots. Black communities were used to the abuse and racism of police officers in LA, and hip-hop has been telling these stories for years. But the videotape from the King beating is what finally gave them a chance to express this anger. A group named NWA came out with The Police, and this was literally the anthem of the LA riots. The song expressed the anger and the violence that was happening explicitly, so everyone could understand how real the violence was becoming. Along with artists like Ice-T, Dr. Dre, and KRS-One, people of all minorities were able to make a big impact upon the American justice system as a whole.
My name is Armani Morris, and I get better every day.
Thank you for everything. Oh, I-